in history. Chee! Make some noise for Nav Bhatia.
Hey, V-Day. Come on, you are not just the NBA champions, you are the real champions. Let's do better than that. Hey, V-Day. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, what a summer we had. Not just Toronto, but all of Canada are the NBA champions. But let me take you back to May 2019. The Raptors in the middle of playoffs. They had just beaten Philadelphia in the seventh game on the final shot. The city was on fire. The Raptors eliminated Philadelphia, and now we are on to Milwaukee Bucks. After losing first two games in Milwaukee, we come back to Toronto for the crucial game three. During the game, my phone keeps buzzing. I don't pay any attention because I'm focused on the game. And we won that game, by the way. The next day, I woke up to this tweet. Everything came to a stop for me. You see, this isn't the first time I have dealt with discrimination. I came to Canada in 1984. I'm a mechanical engineer by education, but nobody wanted to hire me because of turban and beard. After hundreds of interviews, I got a job as a car salesman, and the first day I was called many similar names. I deserve to be there. So to prove it, I worked hard and treated others how I wanted to be treated. I sold, yes? I didn't argue with anybody because they were calling me names. But what I did, I sold 127 cars in 3 months. That was a record at that time. And it is still a record right now. I kept working hard and ended up owning two dealerships. When I started as a salesman, I could have responded in a negative way, but I chose to respond the negativity with positivity. Just like I did when I received this tweet this summer. When I returned to Milwaukee for game five, I didn't know what to expect. To my surprise, Buck fans were coming up to me apologizing for the tweet. But something else happened. Yes, they were coming and apologizing for that particular one fan. They were taking pictures with me, they were hugging me, and all that. People were attacking the person who wrote the tweet as well. I didn't like that. How does that make us any different than him? So I got hold of him, and we spoke on the phone. I will tell you, I have a lot of respect for him to be able to give me a call and face me one-on-one. He apologized, and I gladly accepted his apology. But I put a condition on it. I said, when I come back to Milwaukee, I'm going to take you for a dinner with your family, and then we enjoy the game together. And he accepted that. I ask you all, how would you react? Would you have done the same? V-Day, here is my challenge to you. When you see someone being picked on because of their skin color or their religious belief, at school or at work or online, I challenge you to stand up for them. Let them know they are not alone and respond to negativity with positivity. Thank you, V-Day. And before I go, because you all know this is my home, I spend more time at the Raptors game than I spend at my home. So I want you to do a chant with me on the count of three, we the North. One, two, three. We the North. We the North.
We the North.
We the North. We the North. And let me tell you, one thing. Anybody who is telling us, like Kevin Durant, that we are not going to win another championship, I tell you, we are going to surprise the world again. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Dear future, I know what I want.